Hello, this is Dr. Nick Wirtz here again with another video. Today, I wanted to talk a little bit about the book Rays of the Dawn. It's written by Doctor Thurman Fleet in the 1930s. Doctor Thurman Fleet was a chiropractor. He practiced in San Antonio, Texas. And he was a master healer. He did his work based on the premise that there's three things that cause dis-ease in the human body. One of them is traumas. Another one, and that would be physical traumas. Another one would be toxins. And then the third thing would be autosuggestion. So traumas could be like if you sit with a bad posture all day and you feel tired, drained. Towards the end of the day, that could be a form of trauma, or another form of trauma could be if you get into a really bad car accident. That would create trauma in the body that would interfere with the expression of life in you. Second thing would be toxins. Examples of toxins would be if you were to eat a meal that's unhealthy for you, and several hours later feel drained or zapped. Or another form of toxins could be something as severe as like rat poison or something like that that would cause a severe trauma in the body or severe overload of toxins. Third thing, autosuggestion. This is going to be dealing with negative thoughts, emotions. It's going to be mental, emotional, spiritual stress. When someone has a problem in their body, typically they turn to cleaning up their diet, or they turn to stretching, or improving their exercise. But oftentimes I've noticed that people don't really turn to dealing with the autosuggestive part of their being, the mental, the spiritual, the emotional part. And I think that is part and parcel due to the fact that most people don't know how to tend to those aspects of their being. And Dr. Fleet wrote the book Rays of the Dawn, and it actually talks about how to deal with all three of those components. He has a chapter on nourishment and sanitation. And that's really important for dealing with the chemical body, right? Then there's a chapter on movement and recuperation. Those are really important for dealing with the physical body. But then he also has chapters talking about the mind and the soul. In the mind chapter, he talks about the following emotions. There's fear, there's worry, there's selfishness, vanity, anger, criticism, envy, greed, hypocrisy, prejudice, jealousy, and hate. In the soul chapters about the soul, he talks about faith, hope, generosity, aspiration, patience, sympathy, non-interference, kindness, courage, forgiveness, duty, and love. Okay? And those are all different types of emotions, fear and faith and worry and hope. All different types of emotions with their own vibration. And Dr. Fleet says that when you're resonating in one particular vibration for a long time, it will have an impact on your health. So if you're resonating in the fear vibration or the worry vibration or the anger vibration or the criticism vibration, that's going to have an effect on your health. Just like being hopeful or vibrating in the frequency of aspiration or being kind or courageous or forgiving, that's also going to have its own vibration. And the mind emotions, the emotions that seem more negative, those are going to have a negative impact on your health. So when you're resonating in those frequencies, your body's going to be in a state of dis-ease. Right? When your body's not at ease, in a state of dis-ease, it's not healing as well as it could. Then there's the emotions of the soul. more positive emotions like faith and hope and generosity. Those put your body at ease, put you in a healing mode. And the idea in this book is that we are a soul, right? A life force, an energy that is occupying a body, that is manifesting through a body. We are not a body that has a soul. We are a soul that has a body. And Fleet encourages us to behave like the soul, right? Allow faith, hope, generosity, aspiration, patience, sympathy, non-interference, kindness, courage, forgiveness, duty, and love to permeate through our bodies. And, you know, you can read these chapters and get a sense of just what those are. And it helps you to take an inventory of what type of vibrations you're resonating in your life. And for me, my experience with this book and what I've seen with other people who have studied the book, it's not that you read the chapter once and then get it, right? All of a sudden you read the chapter on faith and all of a sudden you're faithful in every single situation that you deal with. You're never in a state of fear, right? Or it doesn't mean that you're always able to forgive everything that happens to you, right? But by studying these chapters, it helps you realize when you're going through a state where you're having a hard time forgiving or having a hard time being kind or having a hard time being patient. And when you realize that, it's then that you can make a conscious effort to shift your frequency, shift your vibration into one that's more healing, one that's more resonant with the soul. And by doing this, it creates a huge shift in people's health, right? So most people that come into my office, many people who come into my office, they are quite well educated on how to eat properly, right? I think most people, for the most part, have a sense of how to eat fairly well, right? There are exceptions, but we can tell when we eat a good meal that it makes us feel good versus when we eat a crappy meal. It makes us feel crappy, right? So eating is not that complex. If you want, I can do a talk about that. Then there's also so that's the chemical aspect of the being. Then there's the physical aspect, the body, right? We need to exercise. We need to stretch. We need to rest. That's not that complex. But when it comes to the emotional, spiritual, mental side of the being, that's more confusing. And what Dr. Fleet has done with this book, Rays of the Dawn, is just create tools for people to tend to that part of themselves just as they would tend to themselves through exercise or proper diet or rest. So as you start to study it and you understand how to work with these energies, you then can realize when there is a problem that occurs due to an imbalance from not tending to these properties, and you then know how to go in and deal with it, and things become less of a mystery. Your health is less of a mystery. When something goes wrong, it's like, oh, all right, well, I've been upset. I've been angry for the last 2 weeks. Like, no wonder I have this tension in my shoulders and I'm getting a headache and I'm not digesting my food well, right? Makes sense, okay? Then you don't have to freak out. You just shift out of that frequency. Start acting more patient. Start acting more kind. Start being more forgiving, you know? We all have the power to do this. So through studying this book, I've realized that it's a very, very, very powerful tool. And the more I read it, the more I study it, the more it has to offer. It just keeps revealing more and more helpful tools. It's a very, very powerful tool. The person who introduced me to this book, Dr. Pete Goldman, he's been studying the book over 20 years now. And I can have conversations with him about it anytime, and he's happy to talk about it. It hasn't dried up for him. It just keeps providing. So as a healthcare practitioner, I highly recommend people use this tool. Use this tool to help promote better health in their body. And I think that if you do give it a chance and dive into it, you too will realize that it's a very powerful tool that might be filling in some gaps in your understanding of yourself. So, with that being said, I would also like to say that every Thursday night at 7:15 at my office, I host a book club where we study one chapter from the Rays of the Dawn book. I have extra copies of the book at my office. If you ever want to come and listen in, you're welcome to do it. I also do my best to post the talks on Facebook so that if you're not around, you can listen in and follow and get something out of it as well. So, yeah, I just wanted to make this quick video to pay homage to this book because I think it's been a really powerful tool in my healing and also the healing of the people around me. And I think that it's important that people out there know about this. So hopefully this reached somebody who didn't know it existed, and they'll go out and get the book and read it and spend some time studying it and really try to apply some of the information that's talked about in the book for themselves. And I think that they will notice it adds a richness to their life and more ease to their life as well. So thank you for listening. This is Dr. Nick Wirtz at Judas Tree Clinic. If you have any requests for any other videos, please shoot me an email. Let me know. I am always down to make a video about any topic that you want to hear about it. So just let me know. Have a great day. Be well. Bye.